guys, welcome back. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to a new video. I hope you guys had a great weekend, and it's a new week, a new set of responsibilities for the week to come. So here we are. Right now, there are so many sports that I am loving this time of year. I'm a total junkie for sports, you guys. Like, I love it. I don't know. It's the inner competitor in me. I was a competitive gymnast. That's where I started. And so, I don't know. That competition has never really left. So, when it comes to the NFL or F1 or actually the other one that I'm a total junkie for are the tennis Grand Slams. The U.S. Tennis Open for me is like the one. The other one that I really like too is Australia, but I'm just here for all of that. I love it. I love to watch people fight it out, compete. I love to watch people work hard, do well, and reach their goals. I love it. I think it's so great. So I'm loving this time of year. All is good. I had so much engagement and feedback on the last video. I think you guys liked the whole process of what I go through when looking for a bag to pair up with what I'm doing for kind of like everyday stuff. So I love that. I think you guys resonated with that. I've had a request to do eyebrows, so I think that will be my next video. So stay tuned on that if you're looking on how to grow them, how to style them, what to do with them, because eyebrows are funny. They completely frame your face, and they completely allow for your features to come out or not, but they're tricky. Eyebrows are not easy, especially as we start getting older. Like, those eyebrows get a little funky sometimes. So stay tuned on that. That'll be the next video. This video, I wanted to talk to you guys about denim. So I've gotten a few questions about how to style denim, what kind of denim. And denim, for me, has been the perpetual thorn in my side because it's what I wear most. So when it comes to trying to find the perfect denim, I've had a really hard time. I feel like the 90s, 2000s, the denim was good. There was like a huge rise in companies, Frame, Seven for Mankind. Like, there were a lot of companies that came up with like really good denim. And as like the years have passed, probably trying to make more money, their fabrics, their cuts, it hasn't sustained. They have not kept up with the level that they started at. So what I have found for me is rigid denim for me is my best kind of pairing. Stretch is fine. I think with stretch coming into the whole mix in like the 2000s, really accelerated just how common and how often we wear denim, whether it's for black tie, because I've seen Jenna Lyons like rock a black tie look in denim, all the way down to going to the movies for date night. Like, it is part of our everyday life. So stretch really kind of played a part in that, but in my opinion, I do not like stretch in my jeans. I keep going back to that rigid jean. Maybe they're a little bit softer for depending on the style that I'm wearing for that night or what I'm looking for. But for the most part, you guys, the rigid denim is, I think, the most flattering. I think wears the best. I think over time with the washings and the wearings, I think they get better. You know, when you've got the soft denims or the stretchy denims, they don't wear as long. They get crinkly, they get stretched out, they don't hold their color, they don't even hold the way they're cut. And so then you start getting like saggy butt or really weird pleating like around the hip area. So that's what I've been finding with denim. So I said in the last video, Jenna Lyons did for Harper's Bazaar kind of like a tutorial. She just went to her favorite vintage outlet, and I believe it is What Goes Around Comes Around, which is a great place to stop in New York. We might have one here in LA. But I don't think so. I don't think so. But in New York, there is so much that they have curated there. Uber expensive. You definitely pay for, you know, all the vintage handbags, shoes, pants that they have in the store. But they've curated it. So there's like a lot of really nice pieces. So she went through the whole tutorial of why she likes a rigid denim. Levi's, I will say, is probably the one. And old vintage Levi's, not even the new Levi's, because I feel like Levi's also have put stretch in their jeans. And so I don't love it. What I love about the vintage Levi's is they've been worn in so much that it's a flattering look on the body. But you guys, the thing with Levi's and what makes the vintage Levi's so good now is that they have been cut to today's sizing. So what I remember of Levi's in the 90s is that they were not flattering, and I am not a beanpole. So for me, because I had a butt and hips, they just weren't flattering. They were really big, wide-legged, lots of hanging material, and for a small body, that doesn't work. So today, the vintage Levi's have been cut. They've been cut to today's 23, 24, 25, 26 sizes, and so it fits us a lot better, and then we get the vintage jean of, you know, 20, 30 years ago. So I'm going to show you a couple of different pairs that I have. I'm wearing a pair now. I met a friend for breakfast this morning, so I'm going to show you what I'm wearing. The jean that I have on now is a soft denim, a wide leg denim, but there's no stretch to it. So they're not, they don't pull. And that is my biggest thing with a stretch denim, is just that they don't wear well, and then you start to crease and pleat in areas that is not flattering, and it creates a bigger hip, a saggy butt. So that's my thing with denim. So I'm going to show you what I'm wearing today. I'll show you a couple of different favorite denims that I have. You guys have seen them before because I have styled them, I wear them, I've talked about them before. So it'll be a little redundant, but I will go through kind of what I like about them and what I don't like about them. Other than that, you guys, it's all good over here. My hair is so flat today. It's really dry. And when it's really dry, all my curl falls out. So it's really dry, but it's all good. And, other than that, I hope you guys are all great, and I hope you are having a fantastic week. We're on a roll right now. I'm kind of in rhythm, so that's a good thing. I hope to see you guys on Sunday. Leave me your comments. Let me know what you want to see, and we'll talk soon. Okay, guys, so the look that I wore today to breakfast was a cashmere sweater, wide-legged jeans, no stretch. They're soft, but they're no stretch. And then just my New Balance sneakers, a little bit of color. I have them flipped up a little bit so that they're not totally dragging. If I wear heels, then I unfold them so that just the tip of my like boot or pump is showing. When there's too much stretch, for me, they start to squeeze my hips in places that I don't totally love. I do have one pair of stretch denim that I just recently purchased. I did try them on a haul that I did a few videos back. I will also put those on, pair them up with something, but kind of show you the difference between the jean that I'm wearing now that is soft, and then that jean that is also soft, also has cotton, but it's gonna have stretch as well. Okay, next look. Okay, you guys, so I'm just gonna show you two more pairs of jeans. I don't want to get too far down the rabbit hole because you guys have seen these jeans. I haven't purchased anything new. This isn't necessarily like a styling video, but more of like an informational video on how denim kind of works. So I'm going to also keep the same top on, which is a Neely low tan jersey shirt, which I love her brand, by the way, you guys. It's very like effortless, but very clean. And so I wear a lot of her stuff. And if I didn't mention in my opening, like, tutorial, I've got my Shop My page, and I'm gonna try to keep that updated, and I'm gonna try to find what I'm wearing and link it. A lot of my stuff is old though, you guys. Like, I'm not a shopper. I update, but I'm not a shopper, so there's not gonna be a whole lot of turnover, but you'll see. And if you want to, you know, purchase the same thing, it'll all be on that page. The skincare and the makeup, there's not gonna be a lot of turnover there, you guys, because I am not one to experiment. I think it's bad for your skin to try a bunch of different stuff all the time. So that's pretty much gonna stay consistent. And then makeup, you know, I don't wear a whole lot of makeup, so I'm kind of boring there. But I will try to keep the page updated with maybe stuff that I find that's really cute, maybe I can find what I'm wearing, whatever, whatever, you know what I mean? So there's a link in my profile, and I will also try to link it below as well. Okay, so the jean that I have on is the Bacall jean. It's 100% stretch, 100% cotton, and it is a, like a bell-bottom bottom. So the thing with this jean is that it creates, like, see these wrinkles back here? And see, like, this stuff here? If I were to, like, bend down and come back up, see this wrinkle? When you have a heavy denim, that doesn't stay. The thickness of the denim, like, pulls the denim down. So when you've got a stretch on, it just, it stretches, right? It stretches with what you're doing. But over time, it loses its elasticity. And then it's not totally flattering. So I have a butt. So a lot of times it will hold, you know, the fabric in place. But it does sag, and it will sag over time just from wearing it. But I do like these jeans. You know, they are pretty effortless. I would only wear them with a heel because the fabric is a little sloppy just because it's soft. If I'm flat footed or in flat shoes, not attractive, especially if you're 5'2". So if you're tall and you can allow the length of your body to kind of take that jean down, more power to you, and that's awesome. But for me, that would never work. So this is the Bacall, and I don't know who makes them, but I will link them if you guys are interested. Okay, I'm gonna put on a rigid denim Levi. Okay, guys, so for the last pair, it's just my trusty vintage denim Levi. You guys have seen this 5,000 times over, but you just can kind of see how the jean just kind of falls down. When you look at the back, even though there's a crease, it kind of hugs your butt versus kind of hanging down here. And then, like, when you come down and you come up, you see that there's no weird gather. It just kind of stays down. So I love a vintage Levi. It is my favorite go-to. They're a little kind of hard to find, not because you can't find them, but finding, like, the right fit for you and the right cut for you, it takes a little bit of time. If you have, like, a really good seamstress that you can kind of go get a vintage pair and then, you know, cut them back here and cut the width here where they can do, like, really great craftsmanship, that's really the way to go. I've purchased these from Redone, but I think, like, their management or their ownership, it's changed. So the options that they have and what they're showing is not a whole lot of vintage. You'll get them, and I think on the bigger sizes, you're gonna have better luck. So if you're like a 28, 29, you might have better luck than me, that's a 23 or 24. They're not making them, like, as often. So, but that's my deal with a vintage Levi. I think it is the most versatile. I think it is the coolest. It keeps coming back around. Like, vintage Levi's, or Levi's in general, I mean, they've been around forever, right? They're the original jean. So, or maybe some people say Lee. I don't know. I've never tried the Lee jeans on, and I know that what goes around comes around has like vintage Lee jeans too. So I don't know, that might be something to try out. If you do, let me know, because I've never worn a Lee jean. All right, you guys, so that's my 2 cents on what I think about denim. Let me know what you think. What do you think about the stretch in all the jeans? Some people love it, and I get it, because it's probably more comfortable than a rigid jean. But I don't know, I feel like your body's really gotta be on point if it's gonna be real, real stretchy, because when it gets sloppy, you still wanna look good in it, you know what I mean? All right, you guys, hope you're great. Enjoy the rest of your weekend, take it slow, and I hope to see you on Wednesday.